Hi everyone, so we are here at Bricking Bavaria 2025, and for this event I built yet another brick built person transporter. So this is a LEGO built scooter. The only custom part that I used is the 3D printed wheels, and of course it is powered by BuWizz motors and controlled by BuWizz 3.0. In total there are 16 motors, 8 per wheel, and all the motors are integrated inside the wheels. So we have 8 motors for driving the front wheels, 8 motors for driving the rear wheels, and all of those 8 motors are controlled by the 8 BuWizz bricks, 4 in the rear which are shining in red, and then we also have 4 in the front which are shining in white. As you can see, the scooter can steer, and I'm using a phone here to control the motors. So you can go forwards and backwards. Now, this scooter can support my weight, so we give it a quick go. So as you can see, it can just about support my weight. The problem is that it does bend quite a lot under my weight, and balancing is a bit of an issue because it's a bit slow. But if we put a child that's like half my weight, then it works perfectly. So we can give it another try, but I think the best person to carry this, use case is for children. Okay, so let's give it another try. Here are the legs to support it, and as you can see, it can transport me, though I do have a bit of an issue with balance. It would have to be a bit slightly faster to be more stable, but then if I gear it to be even faster, then I will have problem with not having enough torque to move me. So as I said, this can support an adult like me, but it's best suitable for children. Another thing worth mentioning is that after we're done driving, you can transport the scooter really easily. You can remove this white axle and you can simply fold it like this. And if that's not enough, if you need even more space, if you need to take it apart even more, you can also take out this axle, and now it's in two parts. So we have the main body and of course the handlebars, and you can easily reassemble it. Put the axle back in. Do this. Push it through, and now it's again in one part. Originally, there were also panels here in the rear, but during driving, I discovered that they were scratching on the wheel. So later when we get back, I'll move them slightly forward. So these panels in the rear that were supposed to be here were just to prevent you from your feet from touching the rear wheel. But what I wanted to show you here is that you can actually remove the top surface, and you can see the structure inside. So the entire scooter is based on these 3x19 frames. There are around 150 of these. You can see like one here, for example. So it's 3x19 studs. similar to the skateboard. And the most of the construction is based on these frames, plus a few panels, and plus a few shorter version of the beams, which are of the frames, which are here. So you can see the shorter 3x, I think it's 3x13 studs, the shorter version of the same part. And when testing, actually damaged a few, because I later discovered that I have to make it double wide to support the weight. And you can also see there are two empty spaces in here. Now the idea for these two empty spaces is that you could put power banks or spare parts or anything like that in here, so you can store some things inside of the frame of the scooter. So as mentioned earlier, we are using 8 more BuWizz motors per wheel, and all the motors are integrated inside the wheel. You can see just barely see the motors here sticking out and the cables. So these are the motors, 8 BuWizz motors inside the wheels, and each wheel is controlled by 4 BuWizz bricks. So here are the 4 BuWizz 3.0 Pro bricks that are controlling the rear wheel, and I made the lights in red color. Well, the front wheel is basically the same as the rear wheel. The only difference is that it's at a different orientation, and the BuWizz bricks are also placed in a different setup, so they're more shining towards the front and a slightly higher, so that they don't touch the ground. So, and finally, and the at the handlebars, there is the phone that controls all the BuWizz bricks, and I'm just using a simple slider to power on all the 16 motors. So this is about it. In total, I think I used around 4,000 parts for this model. I'm not totally sure yet, because I have yet to update the 3D LEGO Digital Designer file, because I wanted to finish this model physically before going to Bricking Bavaria. But I estimate it's around 4,000 parts, and I think it weighs around, I would say, something between 12 and 15 kilograms. And I think it came out pretty well. The biggest challenge were, of course, the wheels, because with previous models, I had 4 wheels to support the entire weight. Here, I only have 2 wheels that have to support the entire weight of the scooter and the rider, plus there also has to be space inside the wheels for the motors. So I'm really happy how I managed to integrate the motors inside the wheels, and like seeing how children really like riding this, and how it turned out, I'm really happy with this project. Of course, there are issues with bigger, heavier adults like me, but for children, this is just so much fun, and I really like it. And if you like to see models and big projects like this, then please remember to subscribe, like, and share. Thank you very much, and have a nice day. Bye-bye.